who puts the word hardcore into hard drive. Good morning, Nathan.
Good morning, Mike. Another great introduction. Thank you.
I try. But I've learned a new word. It seems to be a week for words. What is Spotify?
Spotify is a hugely popular music streaming service. It originally came from Sweden, and it's huge in the States at the moment and parts of Europe as well. And Spotify have just announced they're launching in Australia and New Zealand.
Okay.
So what Spotify do, streaming music, you have an account that gives you access to 16 million music tracks. So probably enough music to listen to for the rest of your life and probably a bit more.
Yeah.
It's a free trial service initially, and then ongoing it'd be $5 or $10 a month for a subscription service. So basically you can have an application on your phone or you can access it through your computer, and it gives you access to a wider range of music than you may have purchased. You just might not have the files located on your computer. You're just playing it through the internet or through the application on your phone.
Oh, so instead of taking up so much memory on your phone, you can just streamline it.
Yes.
Now, this next one, I know Helen Cooper will be a fan of. Doggy Smart Collar.
Yes. So Fujitsu have developed a device that can tell how your dog is feeling when it's out for a run or lying around the home. It monitors the shivering or external temperature of the dog.
Okay.
So some sort of vital signs.
Mm-hmm.
And experts say that some of these numbers can actually point to obesity or diabetes in a dog.
Okay.
So some indicators. Caters of these. So not only does it monitor the signs, it also sends the information to a phone app.
Right.
Or to a cloud service.
You can at any time monitor the dog's temperature.
Yes.
Its heart rate.
Yes.
Anywhere.
And the amount of steps it's taken as well.
Oh, wow.
So if you're raising money or doing a pedometer for yourself, you can see if your dog's taking as many steps as you are.
Does it have a little chip in it that if the dog's doing the wrong thing, you could press a button and it...
I think that's slightly different, yes.
Oh,
but
not
in those ones where it steps over the boundary of the house and it's back.
Time will tell. Now, last week I linked your Facebook page to the Life FM Breakfast one, and one of the Life FM listeners had a question for you.
Thank you for the question that came through. It asked, how can you change the email details on an iPod to check the activity of a child? To answer that question, all iPods, iPhones, iPads, all the Apple devices,
yep,
they have a thing called an Apple ID, which is basically the account.
Yep.
So you can change the email address through iTunes or through the Apple website.
Okay.
Under the Apple ID section.
Yep.
And I'd recommend also changing the password. A lot of people might have an iPod ID account that's been set up from maybe a couple of years ago from their first iPod.
Yep.
So recommend changing the password so it's only something you know.
Mm.
So the children can't download apps, particularly the in-app content, which is the ones that can rack up large credit card bills. So you're controlling what they download. So that's just from the overall account perspective. But there is actually a very simple setting that all the Apple devices have, a lot of people might not be aware of, called restrictions. So this is just under the settings, and we'll post this on the Life FM Facebook page as well, just so people have links to the page and can follow through the steps. But restrictions are a simple way. You can just set up a PIN number on the phone and have controlled access to individual apps and settings on the phone. So for instance, you can restrict whether there's access to the internet, access to YouTube and the videos that come through there, or whether apps and music can be downloaded as well.
So no longer do you take the child's iPod and you've got to wipe the whole thing to set it up properly.
That's correct. You can just customise certain settings within the iPod or the phone if they're lucky enough to have one.
What happens if there's an app on the phone that doesn't meet the criteria that you've then set?
One of the settings under restrictions is you can adjust the rating level. So if they're a child, they can only play games that are approved for general audience or children.
And the ones that are already on the phone just...
They won't be able to access them or they'll be blocked. And you can also block changes to accounts as well. So children can't set up different email addresses or try and get access and try and bypass. So you can control them individually or you can turn them all off through restrictions with just a simple PIN number.
Nathan, in the world of technology, we rely on you to keep our children safe. Thanks for coming in today.
Thanks again, Mike.
It's easy with Gadget Coach.